Hey everyone, in this video I'm going to show you how to get a big and beautiful sound out of your cheap beginner violin. If that sounds interesting, then hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for free weekly violin lessons. So this is a $29 violin set, so the bow, the violin and the case are together $29, I got from AliExpress. And I just want to bust the myth a little bit, because sometimes people are, of course, very kind to compliment me about my sound or anything, and then they ask what kind of strings you use, what kind of violin or bow do you have, etc., etc. But I just want to give you the message that even though you are not in the position that you can get a very fine instrument and bow, that you can still progress on the violin and still get results. Of course, that doesn't mean that it doesn't pay off to get a good violin, and of course a good violin and bow make it easier to learn and faster. Now, the components of sound are the contact point, so where you are between the bridge and the fingerboard. So you notice that here it sounds soft, and then here it can sound a little bit harsh. You want to stay at the same spot, and that's one of the reasons why it's important to bow straight. You probably heard that before. And you do that with movements in your wrist and fingers, because your arm goes in a circle and you want the bow to go in a straight line. And you compensate that with your wrist and fingers. If you're thinking, oh, I don't know that movement, you know that movement because you're making exactly the same movement if you're throwing away a ball in a straight line. The only thing that makes it more difficult is that you're holding a bow that has a will of its own. So it seems sometimes. Then what you are doing is that in your correct bow that is flexible and relaxed, etc., then you turn the key, so to say, to the left, and you transfer the weight from your arm through your index finger into the bow, into the string. And that's a spring system of your arm, your hands, your fingers, the bow, etc., etc. Now you see that this bow is a little bit wobbly because it's an extremely cheap bow. But let's try to get a good sound anyway. Dig in the bow a little bit, and then I have to compensate for the wobbliness of the bow, so it feels sturdy at the frog and at the tip, but I need a little bit more force in the middle. The bow needs to listen to me. And you want to relax your arm and relax your shoulder. Then you want all the hair to be on the string. So you don't want to tilt your bow only when you want to play softer, but it shouldn't be a habit. And then what you want to do is to have a consistent bow speed. So to not bow like that. Don't slow down and speed up before the bow changes. But try to bow in a consistent tempo, even if you move from down bow to up bow. And with your wrist and fingers, you can move fluently from down bow to up bow, etc., etc. And most people need to have a little bit higher bow speed. So if you have a bow speed that's too low and you put some weight into your bow, you get this. But if you move too fast, then it can be like this. Okay? So try to balance that. You want to play in tune, because then that A string starts resonating along with that first finger on the G. And then what I want you to do when you're practicing putting all these things together is that you stay on one note, just as I did. Just long bow strokes, as many as you need, and keep balancing, keep changing things, keep searching for your sound, because there is no standard formula. You really have to listen and feel for yourself how that all feels. And then on the D string you might need a little bit less weight. Make sure that your arm position is correct. And I've got a whole lesson all about not hitting extra strings and not sounding scratchy. So you want to watch that if you really want to be able to bow in a good way on each string. We do the same thing. We need less weight. otherwise you get this. And the E string is tricky for a lot of people. Play very lightly and fluently. And the thing is, if you're thinking like, yeah, everything is going all right on a G, D and maybe the A string, but on the E string it suddenly squeaks. And then you might be thinking, okay, I'm not doing anything wrong because it works on the other strings, extra string. Well, that's not entirely true because each string responds in a slightly different way and everything that you're doing wrong in your bowing is heard a lot more on that E string. So it just uncovers things that are already there on the other strings. And it's of course hard to play light. You can kind of dig in the string on the G and the D string, but on the E string you just have to bow a little bit more delicately. When you practice this for a while on random notes, taking your time, taking it one note at a time, then you can start applying it in a piece. Let's take a familiar beginner concerto, the Kuechler concerto that I also teach in my free beginner course, to which I'll link right here. And that's how a $29 violin can sound. I wish you good luck practicing all this. Just take it one thing at a time. Don't get overwhelmed by all the things I mentioned in this video. Just save this video somewhere in your playlist and get back to it, implementing it in your playing one by one, because I know it's a lot, certainly if you implement it in a good way. So I hope this is helpful. Could you please let me know in the comments which tip stood out for you most, because that makes clear to me where people are struggling with and what information they need in future videos. Of course, I hope that you stay my student by subscribing to my channel. I've got some awesome stuff there for beginners, intermediate, advanced students, mostly around bowing technique, creating a beautiful tone and expressing yourself in music. Well, happy practicing and I really hope to see you soon again. Bye bye!